Hello, students of science. Let's talk about your skeletal system, how it's there to protect you, and of course, help you move. So your skeletal system, everybody moves. Without our bones, we would just be a pile of mush. And there, of course, Barney the dinosaur killed in a tragic children's TV show incident. Let us speak of it no more. All right, the human skeleton. In the adult human, there's about 206 bones. We're going to learn the names of a lot of those later on, but for now, you need to know about 206 when you're a full-grown adult. And there, it's kind of divided up into two big categories. You've got your axial skeleton, that's about 80 bones, and that's going to kind of support the central axis of the body. That's, of course, your skull, your rib cage, and your vertebral column. And then you have your appendicular skeleton, which is about 126 bones. These, of course, are your arms, your legs, your pelvis, and your shoulder area. And these are generally unfused to allow for greater movement. So in your axial skeleton, all those bones right there are going to be kind of fixed in place. Their purpose is not so much to allow movement. Their purpose is there more for protection. Appendicular skeleton, of course, you need these things to be a little bit more free to move so you can move. Great picture of the human skeleton there, worth pausing and looking over. Now, your skeleton has to accomplish a bunch of things. Your skeleton, of course, has to support your body. It's got to make sure that you don't just kind of fall down as a pile of mush. So the skeleton has to support the body and protect the internal organs. So this is the axial skeleton that I mentioned before. Your cranium, of course, is there to protect your brain. Your ribs are there to protect your heart and your lungs. And your vertebrae have something very, very important on the middle. That, of course, is your spinal cord, the nerve signals that travel down from your brain to the lower parts of your body. And, you know, without it, you're in trouble. So your skeleton right there, its job is to protect you. And there it's, of course, to protect your brain, which you can kind of see inside this cutaway view there. Your skeleton also needs to assist in movement, whether it's getting up and moving and walking around, or whether it's just, you know, inhaling and exhaling. You know, your skeleton is there to hold your thoracic cavity open so you can actually get oxygen in. Of course, your skeleton is also going to be storing minerals like calcium that you've probably heard about, but they're active players in this. If there's not enough calcium in the blood, they're going to essentially pull some out of the bones. If there's too much, they're going to put it into the bones. It's a great way to store as necessary. And of course, your skeleton is also there to form your blood cells in a process called hematopoiesis. And we're talking both white blood cells, the ones that go around and fight infection, and red blood cells, the ones that carry oxygen. Both of those are actually made inside your bones. You think that it's a blood thing. No, it's actually your skeleton made those, or the bone marrow. Without a skeletal system, of course, you'd collapse like a thing of putty, and that seems terrible. So, you know, let's be thankful that we have a skeleton. All right, so let's talk about your bone structure, and I want you to draw this in, and I'm going to be kind of going from the outside, working my way to the inside. Now, of course, on the outside of your bones, you have this tough outer layer of connective tissue that you can see it kind of being peeled back a little bit here. Underneath that, you have this thick layer of what is called compact bone, very, very tightly packed there, because underneath that, we have the spongy bone. Now, despite its name, it's actually very, very strong. It's just kind of got these holes, these openings in there to, you know, make the bones a little bit lighter. But despite that, it's honeycombed with it, but it's still very, very strong. Underneath that, we have the soft tissue, the marrow. And here you can see an example of marrow. The red stuff here is the red bone marrow, where it's going to be making red blood cells, and then the yellow bone marrow, that's going to be made out of fat cells there. So the red marrow, this is where all of your blood cells are being made, both white and red blood cells, and your yellow, that's going to be made out of more fat cells. You can kind of see another cutaway view. You got the connective tissue, then we have the compact bone. Underneath it, we have the spongy bone. And then, of course, the marrow would be running down the middle where the new blood cells are being made. Now, embryos, when they were developing, they started out as all cartilage and no bones. Cartilage is slowly replaced over the course of development in a process called ossification. In this case right here, or os just means bone. Maybe you've heard of osteoporosis. So ossification is where you're essentially going to be replacing all of the cartilage there, and you can see this big open area there. You're going to be placing that with bone. And this happens about 7 months prior to birth when you're about 2 months along in your development. You can kind of see further on, I think this is about 5 months, you can see the areas where the bones have yet to grow and the areas where the bones are actually replacing the cartilage. Children are born with about 270 bones, but during growth and development, as you get older, some of those bones are going to fuse, bringing it down to the 206 that you have when you're an adult. You can even see how babies are, when they're minutes after birth, they kind of got the whole cone head thing going on. That's because the bones in their head haven't entirely fused. Eventually, when you get older, those will fuse. You know, those joints there don't allow for a lot of movement, but you do need to be a little bit more flexible during birth, especially if it's a natural childbirth instead of a C-section. If they're going down the birth canal, it's a tight fit, which any mother probably is very aware of. So as one of the things evolution has done is it allows the baby's heads to be a little bit more flexible so they can make it through there. Doesn't make it easy, but it protects the child and it makes it a little bit easier on the mother. But, you know, it still looks like it sucks. Joints. Joint is where you're going to have two or more bones actually connecting. So you have this connective tissue that's actually going to be holding bones together while allowing movement. Ligaments are the things that connect bone to bone. Maybe you heard of the ACL ligament there, the anterior cruciate ligament. That's going to be the one that's connecting bone to bone. So ligaments are bone to bone. Tendons are going to be muscle to bone, which you'll see later on when we talk about the muscular system.